Hola amigos, bienvenidos de nuevo a edupediaworld.com al nivel intermedio de español. Hablemos español una vez más. Let's continue speaking Spanish. On the previous video, we were studying some basic phrases that are going to be useful for you in order to have a conversation with someone else. Today, we're going to learn some common expressions that are related to parts of the body and colors, and they are very common in a normal conversation or in an everyday conversation with someone else. If you use these phrases, you can even be considered almost a native speaker. So let's start. Comencemos a ver cuáles son estas frases. Veamos estas frases. There are some expressions that are related with the parts of the body. For example, in English you have pull my leg. He is pulling my leg, to say that he's making a joke or he's making fun of me. He's making a fool out of me. But in Spanish you also have another expressions that are related to parts of the body and have different meanings according to your intention. Veamos estas frases. Por ejemplo, en español, con la cabeza, with the head, puedes decir estar mal de la cabeza. Being he's not doing well about his or her head. He's not okay. His head is not okay. Estar mal de la cabeza. Por ejemplo, ese chico está mal de la cabeza. That boy is out of his head or bad from, he has something bad in his head. When you use this in Spanish, you want to say that that person is a little bit crazy or is doing something that is not very logical, okay? It's not a very good phrase to talk about someone else. Ese chico está mal de la cabeza. Con las cejas, the eyebrows, you have the expression entre ceja y ceja, between the middle of the eyebrows. Entre ceja y ceja. Tengo este proyecto entre ceja y ceja. I have this project in the middle of my eyebrows. With this, you want to say that you're almost obsessed with that idea. In this case, the project. It's an idea you have and you firmly believe in it, and you are, as I said before, you are almost obsessed with that. Es pensar firmemente en algo. With the face, cara, tienes la expresión cara dura. Be a cara dura. Dura is hard. But when you're using in Spanish with cara, cara dura, is to describe a person that is not ashamed of doing something bad in front of you or in front of someone else. Por ejemplo, ese chico es un cara dura. Sale con mi amiga y mi prima. That boy is cara dura. He goes out with my friend and my cousin at the same time. As you see, this boy doesn't care about the fact that he's going out with two girls at the same time. That's why you say he's a cara dura. Con la oreja, the ear, you have parar la oreja, like stand the ear, would be the literal translation, of course. Paren la oreja. Esta información es muy importante. You say this when you want to make to focus that what you're going to say or what is going to be said is very relevant or important. So you ask the person to stand the ear, literally, parar la oreja. Tener el corazón en la boca, having your heart in your mouth. This expression is used when you're afraid, when you're very stressed or worried about something. Cuando estás preocupado, inquieto, estresado por algo. Por ejemplo, tenía el corazón en la boca porque no llegabas. I have the heart in my mouth because you didn't arrive. Estaba preocupada. Tenía el corazón en la boca porque no llegabas. Con los codos, the elbows, you have it. Hablar hasta por los codos. Speak even with your elbows. Ese niño habla hasta por los codos. That boy speaks even with the elbows. When you say this, as you can see, you just say that that person talks a lot. But really a lot. Habla muchísimo. Hablar hasta por los codos. Con el pie, the foot, you can use the word pata. Pata is used for the legs of the animals in Spanish. But with the expression meter la pata, put the foot in the wrong place, meter la pata, is used, as I said before, sorry, is used to say that you made a huge mistake. For example, metí la pata al comprar eso. I made a huge mistake buying that. When you did something really wrong. Meter la pata. También tienes con la mano, the hand, dar una mano, give a hand. When you want to ask or offer help. ¿Me puedes dar una mano con este mueble? Can you give me a hand with this piece of furniture? Para ofrecer ayuda o solicitar ayuda, help. There are another expressions that are related with colors, expressions that are used in everyday conversations. Algunas expresiones con colores son estas que vamos a ver. Por ejemplo, vamos a ver unas con el color verde. Estar verde de envidia. Being green of envy. Of course, as the expression says, you are so envy of the other person that you're green. It's not literal, but you're feeling a lot of envy towards that person. Estaba verde de envidia al verla con ese vestido. When she saw her with that dress, she was green of envy. Estar verde de envidia. Con verde también tienes la expresión comerse las verdes y las maduras. Eating the green and the ripe. Madura is the expression for the fruit that is already ready to be eaten. And verde, of course, is when the fruit is not ready yet. So when you say comerse las verdes y las maduras, is to go through difficult or happy situations. This is usually used with when you're talking about your experience with other person. For example, nos hemos comido las verdes y las maduras y seguimos aún juntos. We have eaten the green and the ripe and we are still together. Nos hemos comido las verdes y las maduras y seguimos juntos. This is used for couples, for example. Con verde también tienes la expresión viejo verde. He's an old green man. Viejo man, viejo verde, or green old man, sorry. In Spanish, you use the expression viejo verde for a man that is, or that has already certain age to be considered a little bit old and goes after ladies or women that are younger than him, but a lot. They are much younger than him. So, in Spanish, you use the expression viejo verde. Ese señor es un viejo verde. That man is a green old man. Es un viejo verde. Y también puedes usar la expresión estar verde en algo. You can be green at doing something. And this is used when you're starting to learn to do something, where you're just a beginner. Por ejemplo, Ana apenas empieza en el trabajo. She just started at that new job. Aún está verde en organizar archivos. She's still green when it comes to organizing the files. You see? Estas son las expresiones con el color verde. Veamos algunas expresiones con los colores negro, blanco y gris. You have also more expressions with black, negro, blanco, white, and gris, gray. Veamos con negro. Con negro puedes tener ver todo negro, see everything green. And this is to have a very negative perspective, very negative attitude towards something that is happening or the future of or what is going to happen after something. For example, el equipo va perdiendo. Veo todo negro para ellos. The team is losing. I see everything green for them. You have no positive perspective in the future for the team. No tienes una proyección positiva, así que todo es para una persona pesimista. Ver todo negro. Dinero negro, black money, is the money that is not that is acquired by means that are not very honest or legal. This is money that is obtained in an illegal way. For example, los traficantes manejan dinero negro. The dealers, or I don't know, maybe robbers or dealers, manejan dinero negro. They have black money. They work with black money. el humor negro, black humor, when they have these kind of expressions or jokes that are funny, but they can be sometimes a little bit strong for some persons. They can also be sarcastic or sometimes sad. For example, es una serie de humor negro. It's a series with black humor. With white, con el color blanco, tienes quedarse en blanco. Staying or becoming white. Quedarse en blanco. Cuando olvidas algo, when you forget something and you stay with your mind, like a blank space in your mind, you use the expression quedarse en blanco. Por ejemplo, durante la exposición, quedé en blanco y no pude continuar. During the presentation, I became white, quedé en blanco, and I couldn't continue, no pude continuar. Quiere decir que olvidé lo que iba a decir. I totally forgot what I was going to say, so I couldn't continue. Dar en el blanco, to hit in the right spot. Dar en el blanco, hit in the white. Of course, blanco is used to that little part of the target when you're playing with darts. That is the blanco, the center. And when you say dar en el blanco is when you make the right decision, when you hit just the right opportunity in the right moment with the right result for you. Por ejemplo, diste en el blanco al escoger ese traje. You hit in the right target, or diste en el blanco when you chose that suit. You made the right decision. De punta en blanco, use when you're talking about the appearance of the person and the way that person is dressed. When a person has the perfect outfit from head to toes, de pies a cabeza, dices que está de punta en blanco. Por ejemplo, Alberto siempre está de punta en blanco. Alberto is always de punta en blanco. Punta is the point. Like the principal part of something. But when the expression says that or makes reference to a person that is perfectly dressed and clean, that has a perfect look. De punta en blanco. Con gris puedes tener la expresión ser una persona gris, being a gray person. And this is used for a person that is not very enthusiastic, that is not very cool and doesn't want to talk to anybody. Sometimes it can be a little bit pessimist and not talking too much, a little bit shy and always thinking in a negative way. Esto es ser una persona gris. Por ejemplo, a ellos no les agrada Luis. Es una persona muy gris. They don't like Luis because he's a very gray person. Es una persona gris. Tienes más expresiones con colores y tenemos ahora colores muy femeninos, very girly colors, because they are the pink. Con el rosa tienes varias expresiones en español. Por ejemplo, ser color de rosa, being pink color. En la vida no todo es color de rosa. In life, not everything is pink. When you use this, you want to say that when you use the expression color de rosa is that everything is pretty and perfect and beautiful. And the expression says, and the phrase, as the example says, in life, not everything is pink. You can have beautiful things, but not so beautiful things. Ser color de rosa. Con color de rosa también tienes ver la vida, see the life in pink. For example, para Elena todo es bonito. Ella ve la vida color de rosa. For Elena, everything is pretty, everything is unique. She sees life in pink. Ella ve la vida color de rosa. Esto es tener una actitud positiva frente a la vida, having a positive attitude towards life and the things that happen to you. Ver la vida en color de rosa. Sometimes it can be. It can also make reference to a person that is a little bit naive, you see, that believes in everything and for whom everything is perfect and pretty and beautiful, okay? So be careful when you use it. La prensa rosa, the pink journals, is when used for the kind of journals or magazines that present the love comments or gossip about famous people. For example, los chismes de las parejas del momento están en la prensa rosa. The gossip of the couples of the moment are in the pink journals or pink magazine. The pink media, la prensa rosa. Con otros colores como el azul y el rojo, blue and red, puedes tener estas expresiones. Por ejemplo, con el rojo tienes estar al rojo vivo, being at the heat of the moment. La discusión está al rojo vivo. When something is when there's a lot of tension, or when the discussion or the debate is on the climax of the moment, It's on the very on the highest part of that debate when it's happening. So that is estar al rojo vivo, something that is very, very controversial sometimes, or you feel the tension and the emotion. It's on the highest level of emotion or stress or importance. La discusión está al rojo vivo. The discussion is at the heat. Está al rojo vivo. Ponerse rojo, getting red, is when you're embarrassed or you feel shy about something. Por ejemplo, Pedro le dio un beso en la mejilla y de inmediato Ana se puso roja. Pedro gave her a kiss on the cheek and immediately Ana got red. Con azul tienes príncipe azul. In English, you say prince charm, the charming prince or prince charming. And in Spanish, we relate it to the blue color. Príncipe azul. Miriam sueña con el hombre perfecto, su príncipe azul. Miriam dreams about the perfect man, her prince charming, príncipe azul. Y también usamos la expresión sangre azul, blue blood, when the person is related to royalty, or the person we're talking about is a prince or a princess or duchess, duchess. For example, el prometido de Elisa es de sangre azul. Elisa's fiance has blue blood. Maybe he belongs to the royalty, or his family makes part of a royal family. Okay. So, thank you very much for watching us. En el próximo video veremos más expresiones. On the next video, we're going to see more expressions and idioms that will be helpful for you when speaking to a native Spanish speaker. So, thank you very much one more time. Gracias una vez más por vernos y hasta pronto.